Hey everyone, welcome back to the CNATT channel. In this video, we'll show you how to delete and recreate a USB flash drive partition in Windows 11, which can help fix partition errors, securely remove old data, change file systems, resize storage space, and even prepare your drive for creating bootable media. We will teach you how to do this using two methods, one with disk management and the other with command prompt. If you encounter any issues with the first method or prefer using commands, feel free to jump to the second method. Let's dive right into it. The advantages of deleting and recreating a USB flash drive partition. Fixing partition errors. If your USB drive is corrupted or malfunctioning, deleting and recreating the partition can resolve issues, making the drive usable again. Removing old data. Deleting a partition removes old data, providing a clean slate for new use or storage. Changing file systems. You can switch the USB drive's file system, example from FAT32 to NTFS or XFAT, to improve compatibility or performance. Resizing storage space. You can reallocate the entire drive's storage or divide it into multiple partitions based on your needs. Creating a bootable USB drive. This is often used when setting up a bootable USB drive for OS installation or recovery. Method 1. Managing your USB drive partition with disk management. The first step is to plug your USB flash drive into your computer. Once it's detected, open the disk management tool, which is built into Windows 11. To do this, right-click the Start button or press Windows key X on your keyboard, then select Disk Management from the menu that appears. This tool allows us to view and manage the partitions on our USB drive. Once Disk Management opens, look for your USB flash drive in the list. It should be labeled as removable with its storage capacity listed. Be careful here. Make sure you're selecting the correct drive. Accidentally selecting your main drive could cause serious problems. There are several ways to ensure you select the correct USB drive. 1. Match the drive letter or volume label. In disk management, you can match the drive letter or volume label with the one shown in this PC. For example, the drive letter of our USB flash drive is E and the volume label is CNATT USB. 2. Check the size. You can also verify the correct drive by checking its size in disk management. For instance, the size of our USB flash drive is 64 GB. Our 64 GB USB shows about 59 GB because manufacturers and Windows use different storage measurement systems. 3. Eject and refresh method. Another way is to eject the flash drive via safely remove hardware. Then, remove the USB flash drive from the computer and click Refresh from the Action menu in Disk Management. One of the disks will disappear from the list. Reconnect the USB flash drive to the computer, refresh the disk again, and the newly added disk will be the USB flash drive. Now that you're sure you've selected the correct drive, let's delete the current partition. Right-click on the partition of your USB flash drive and select Delete Volume. A warning will pop up telling you that all data will be lost. If you've backed up your files, click Yes to proceed. After deleting the partition, your USB drive will show up as unallocated space in Disk Management. To recreate the partition, right-click on the unallocated space and select New Simple Volume. This will open the New Simple Volume wizard. In the wizard, you'll need to configure the size of partition. Typically, you'll just want to use the full size of the drive, so leave the default settings and click Next. However, if you plan to partition your USB drive into multiple parts, adjust the size accordingly before proceeding. Then, assign a drive letter. Windows will suggest one automatically, so you can usually accept that. Next, you'll be prompted to format the new partition. Make sure the file system is set to NTFS, XFAT, or FAT32. NTFS and XFAT work well for most modern USB flash drives, but some devices still require FAT32 for compatibility. Note that the maximum size of a USB flash drive that can be formatted with the FAT32 file system using standard Windows tools is 32GB. However, FAT32 can technically support partitions up to 2TB, but Windows built-in tools impose a 32GB formatting limit. Third-party software can be used to format larger drives with FAT32. The volume label is the name of your USB drive, making it easier to identify. Choose a simple, descriptive name like Backup Drive or My USB, which will appear in this PC alongside the drive later. Choose Quick Format and click Next. Finally, click Finish to complete the process. You can now access the USB flash drive through this PC or by right-clicking on the newly created partition and selecting Open or Explore. If you plan to partition your USB drive into multiple parts and didn't allocate the full size of the drive for the first partition, right-click on the unallocated space in Disk Management, select New Simple Volume, and create another partition. Method 2. Managing your USB drive partition with Command Prompt. First, we need to open Command Prompt as an administrator. Open the Start menu or press the Windows key, type CMD, right-click on Command Prompt, and select Run as Administrator. If prompted, click Yes to allow it to make changes to your device. Now, we'll use the Disk Part tool to manage the partitions. In the Command Prompt window, type the following and press Enter. Disk Part. This will open Disk Part, a built-in utility for managing disks. To view a list of all connected disks, including your USB drive, type the following command and press Enter. List space disk. Look for your USB flash drive in the list, identified by its size. On our computer, it's disk 2. Now, we need to select the USB drive to work on. Type the following, replacing 2 with the number of your USB disk. Select space disk space 2. This tells Disk Part that we'll be working with the specific drive. Next, to delete all existing partitions on the USB drive, type clean. This wipes the drive by removing all partitions, leaving the disk unallocated. Now that the drive is clean, let's recreate a new partition. To create a primary partition that uses the entire space, type create space partition space primary. This sets up a new partition on the USB drive. To format the new partition, type the following to use the NTFS file system and perform a quick format. Format space fs equals NTFS space quick. If you prefer XFAT or FAT32 for better compatibility with more devices, replace NTFS with XFAT or FAT32. As mentioned in step 1, you can only format a USB flash drive smaller than 32GB to the FAT32 file system using Windows built-in tools. Now, assign a drive letter to the newly created partition. Type assign. Disk Part will automatically assign an available letter to the drive. To manually assign a specific drive letter to a partition in Disk Part, you can use the following command. Assign space letter equals Y, where Y can be any letter that is not already assigned to a drive. Finally, type exit. This closes Disk Part. Your USB drive is now ready with a new partition. Change the drive letter of a USB drive in Windows 11. If you need to change the drive letter of your USB drive in the future, you can do so using Disk Management. Right-click on the Start button or press Windows X on your keyboard. Select Disk Management from the menu. In the Disk Management window, find your USB drive in the list of disks. It will typically be labeled as removable. Right-click on your USB drive and select Change Drive Layer and Paths. Click on Change in the new window. From the drop-down menu, select a new layer that is not currently in use. Example, E, F, etc. Click OK to confirm your choice. A warning may appear informing that some programs may not work correctly if you change the drive layer. Click Yes to proceed. Your USB drive now has a new layer assigned to it. You can access it using the new layer from the SPC. This method is helpful for managing multiple drives or when you want to standardize drive layer for easy access. And that's it! You've successfully deleted and recreated the partition on your USB flash drive. If you found this tutorial helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up and leave a comment down below if you have any questions or suggestions for future videos. Don't forget to subscribe for more tech tips, and I'll see you in the next video.